Hello guys, let's now understand how can we apply colors by using CSS. So how can we apply colors to the text? So for that there we have different ways of doing this. So we can apply colors by name, then we have something called as RGB values and hex values. So let's see one by one in detail. So first of all, I have taken this basic code in which I have printed a H1 statement and then a paragraph, okay, and right now the browser is looking like this, okay. So I'll refresh it. So currently our content is something like this. Now let's color this. So right now the color of this heading is black. So what I'm going to do, currently in the styles there is nothing, so I'm going to select it using the ID tag. So I'm going to write ID equals first head, okay, and then I'm going to color it using the name, okay. So hash first head, and I have to set its color as suppose red, and once I save it, you can see now the color will be changed to red, okay. So this is the first way of coloring the text or any values. The second way is RGB values, okay. So let's try coloring it using that way. So instead of red, what I can do is I can write RGB, okay, and here I have mentioned these all values. So once I refresh it, you can see right now the color is black only, but if I'll put a specific value over here, suppose 255, and for green I'll put 0, and for blue also I'll put 0, okay. So now the color will be red because I have set the value of red as 255. So these values ranges from 0 to 255. If we will set this as 0 and green as 255, then the value will, then the color will be green, okay. So in this way we can make different combinations, like 255 over here, so we will have a different combination of colors. So you can see this is the color that we have got. So in this way we can make use of red, green and blue. Apart from this, we also have after RGB we also have a which stands for alpha, okay. So alpha is basically used, so alpha is a number first of all between 0 to 1, and it is used for transparency, okay. So 0 means not transparent at all, so 0 means fully transparent, and 1 means not transparent at all. So if I'll set the value as 0.5 and let's put the color as blue, so I'll make this as 0 and this is 255 and this is 0. And once I hit save, now let's see, you can see the transparency is in between, like 0.5. so if I'll make this value as 1, so you can see now that it is not at all transparent, okay. And if I'll put it at 0, it will be fully transparent, so we cannot see anything, but still you can see the text is there. So this is the use of A, that is alpha. So apart from RGB, we also have hex values, or called as hexadecimal values, wherein what we need to do is, how do we mention this hexadecimal values? By using this hash symbol, and after that what we will do is we will put the values, that is the hexadecimal values for the colors. For example, if I have to make the color orange, so what I can do is FF6347. Once I hit save and let's refresh it, you can see the color is now orange. So similarly, you will get the hexadecimal codes on the internet for different colors, and you can make use of them. So hexadecimal, it is important that you know that how these values are set. So these first two values are for red, and these second in the middle two values, that is 63, is for green, and the last two values are for blue. So these values are the RGB values only, but they are represented in hexadecimal. Similarly, if you have to represent only using RGB, you can mention it inside the brackets in the previous manner like we have done. So in these ways you can display different colors. So that's all about colors. If you have any doubts, let me know in the comment section. Make sure to subscribe to the channel if you are new to the channel. Thanks for watching the video.